Hello everybody, this is HearthSync with ArdaCraft, and I'm going to show you how to install our mod pack, as well as join our server. Now, returning viewers may recognize that I made a video a few months ago. However, we have made two changes. We have switched to Fabric, which is going to be a huge performance increase that many people are happy about, and we've also switched from CurseForge. But the overall process is still roughly the same. You're going to go to our website, ardacraft.me, and then you're going to click on the top link for our mod pack. Here you can see the video for installing our mods, and a new description at the bottom for steps of how to use the AT Launcher, which is what we're going to be doing today. So you're going to click download the AT Launcher, and there's a few different ways you can go about this, multiple versions for those who are interested in the technicalities. But we are going to click on the setup that is recommended for Windows. I have Firefox, so it's going to show up here. And upon that ding, you're going to see a wizard for installing the ATLauncher. We are going to click Next. We want to accept this agreement. Feel free to read for those who are legally minded. Click Next. It's going to give you an option to set up a profile anywhere on your computer you want. I'm going to go with the default because I like it easy. It's also going to install Java for you, so for those who have used other launchers in the past, you're no longer going to have to manually install Java. I'm going to click Next. You can choose to opt into creating a desktop shortcut. Then we're going to hit Install. Now we are going to click Finish. It's going to be automatically selecting to launch the AT Launcher. This window here, you may not ever have to utilize it, but these are your logs in case there is any errors that you have. I'm going to click Save. Now, what we want to do first is make sure that you're logged in. You're going to go to Accounts, and you can manually enter in your information. However, the easiest way to go about this might be to log in directly with your Microsoft account. Now, I've got my own account here, so make sure you have your own setup. Upon clicking Login, you're going to see Login Complete. You can now close this window and go back to the launcher. Now, the next thing we want to do is we want to click on Packs. We use ModRinth to host our files. So, once you've clicked on ModRinth, you can click Search and type ArdaCraft. And then select New Instance, and then Install. Okay, that took a few minutes for everything to install, but the good news is, if you've done it once, you don't have to do it again. Now, we are going to click on Instances, as we are currently on the pack screen, and you'll see that you can now play ArdaCraft. But before we do so, we want to go over here to Settings. We want to click on Java/Minecraft. And something we want to do is we want to make sure that our RAM is above 8 gigabytes. This is 8,192. This is just going to make sure that you're getting the most optimized playthrough. Now, we're going to click Save. And then, click Play. Okay, and after it spends a few seconds here in the console, doing some initial loading, you're now going to see that a Minecraft instance for ArdaCraft has opened up. I think full screen will do us some justice. Okay, and for most people, myself included, that would have taken a few minutes. However, once things are launched, all you have to do is click Join Server. Alright, and you should be now logged in, and you'll be in our starting area, where you can choose to go straight into the world, or go through our short tutorial. I thank you for watching this video once more, and enjoy your journey in Middle-earth.